Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how ListView works in Salesforce Lightning. If you want to follow Salesforce training videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube and you can follow my YouTube channel. Now coming on to the topic. So for understanding how ListView works in Salesforce Lightning, I am opening my university app where various tabs are available related to objects. So I am clicking on books tab, which is related to book object. So here you can see list views are available. So if I click on this drop down, so only two list views are available here, recently viewed and all. So recently viewed list view shows the records which you visited recently. And if you click on all, so all the available records that are accessible by this logged in user will be displayed. Right now you can see pinned list. So by default, recently viewed is pinned. If you want to pin this all, so you can select all and click on this pin this list view. So now you can see all is pinned and recently viewed is not pinned. So if I click on student and then move to books, so by default it will show all available records, right? And if you want to change the pin, then you can select recently viewed and click on this pin. So this time you can see recently viewed is pinned by default. So whenever you navigate to this tab, recently viewed records will be displayed only, right? So this way we can pin a particular list view for our UI perspective. Now there is a drop down that is known as list view controls. So from here you can create new list view and you can do more things also. So let's modify this all list view first. So now you can see new, clone, rename, sharing setting, edit list filters, select fields to display and delete. All these options are activated. So if you want to delete, so simply you can select this. Now, if you want to select fields to display, so here you can see only book number field is displayed. Now I'm going to click on this and I want author name as well. I want book name. I want book price to be displayed. I want student to whom this book is issued. Right, I want discount. Now I want discount just after price, so click on discount and move it up. So this way you can add the fields that you want to display on a particular list view. So I'm clicking on save. So you can see all these fields are available now. So this way you can show fields on a particular list view, whichever field you want to display, right? So then edit list filters. So we can apply filters from here. Filter means a particular criteria. So I'm going to apply a criteria on price. If price is more than zero, then only those records will be displayed. So I'm clicking on add filter. From here, I'm selecting price greater than zero. Done. So list view is updated and here you can see only two records are displayed whose book price is greater than zero, right? So this way you can apply filter logic. Then sharing setting comes. So there are three options. You can choose first if you want to allow this list view for you. If you want all users can see this list view, you can select second option. So this help text, including partner and customer portal users as well. Sharing list view with groups of users. So you can select roles or roles and subordinates from here. If you don't select any groups, this list view is private, right? So by default, this is selected. So I'm leaving it as it is. Then if you want to rename this, so right now its name is all, you can change it. Then if you want to clone it, so the settings which are applied on this list view will be cloned and a new list view will be created with same settings. And if you want to create a list view from the beginning, then you can click on new, right? So if I click on new, so you need to provide a list view name, its API, then sharing setting, and then further you can apply more things. So let's first remove filter criteria from here. And now I'm going to create new list view. So list view name is books having price populated, right? All users, and clicking on save. So here you can see this new list view is added, but it is showing book number as a field. So we need to add fields here. So you need to click on select fields to display. So I am selecting author name, book name, then I'm selecting price, then let's say discount and final price, right? Clicking on save. So all these fields are available now. Now we need to display only those books whose price is populated. So we need to apply a filter. So from here I'm selecting price greater than zero. So here you can see filter is applied properly, right? So if you want to apply more filters, you can click on this and you can add more settings. If you want to remove all filters, you can click here. So filters will be removed. Then this is another filter which says filter by owner. So you want to display all books, my books, and queue owned books. So it says queue is not available because you do not have any queues to filter by. So right now in this org, any queue is not available, but if queue is available, then you can select this option, as well, right? So this way you can apply filters. So I hope you understood all these features of list view, how we can control list views in Salesforce Lightning. And now if you want to pin this up, so you can just click on this. So by default it is pinned up. So always this list view will be displayed whenever you navigate to this tab, books. So I hope you understood whatever I demonstrated in this video. If you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube and you can follow my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this video.